For many Mauritians, the cane field is the workplace. This is the beginning of sugar. As the sugar planters prepare this year's crop, the previous harvest has already found its way onto the shelves of your supermarket. Mauritius cultivates two main crops, sugarcane and tea. But sugar is the backbone of the island's economy. It has proven to be the only cash crop capable of withstanding the periodic cyclones. Cane fields occupy more than 90% of the arable land. They line every road and are broken only by huge piles of volcanic boulders cleared to make way for the crop. All sorts of vegetables are intercropped between rows of sugarcane. The island's volcanic origin does not make for ideal conditions for mechanization. Apart from huge rocks which have to be cleared from wide areas, stones and other rubbish have to be separated from the cane on their arrival at the sugar factory. Almost every part of the cane is used up. The discarded cane or bagasse is used as fuel for the factory. It feeds the cattle, provides some of the electricity on the island, and contributes to the making of furniture. The juice is turned into rum and cocktails. Like every country which has tried to make its living from the world sugar market, Mauritius has felt the pinch. It got caught in the classic squeeze of rising costs and falling prices. The late 70s and early 80s were hard times for the economy. An increasing number of well-educated young people were reluctant to work as laborers in the cane fields. Apart from a crippling economic crisis, there was also great political unrest. Industrial relations in the harbor and transport industry were poor. Cane was burnt in the fields, and the sugar industry suffered as a consequence. The problem was largely solved in 1980 when a bulk sugar terminal was built. It cut the cost of loading ships to a minimum. I was in Mauritius that year and captured on 8mm film the last working day of these débardeurs. For years, these men had loaded ships in this rather primitive way in the scorching sun of Polwi. The sugar terminal brought an end to these labor-intensive scenes. Almost overnight, these huge sugar containers appeared in the streets of Mauritius and have now become a familiar sight. In spite of their quibbles, especially over independence, our leading politicians of that era have gained worldwide respect for their vision and determination. Because in the end, they produced what the country needed in order to bring its people out of the depth of despair. Mauritius diversified from sugar, and Mauritians went to work. The export processing zone provides much needed employment.
pays natal, mais moi n'ai la monnaie, mon papa mandé. Même la case en paille, tout qui dit l'eau m'a tombé d'oubli. Mauritius, mon pays natal, mais moi n'ai la monnaie.
This small but great nation emerged from those difficult years stronger and healthier. Its people have good reasons to be proud of calling themselves Mauritians. In its attempt to diversify from sugar, the Mauritius government has wisely laid great emphasis on tourism, for which the island is ideally suited. Mauritius scores highly as an ideal place to get away from it all. It has everything which holiday brochures are made of. A number of high-standard hotels have been built around the coastline. Young Mauritian men and women provide an exemplary service, always with a smile. Mauritians are known for their friendliness, a tourist attraction in itself. The guests here are very well looked after and are in for a real treat. In addition to the water sports, a wide range of activities can be enjoyed in the hotel gardens, catering for all ages. Tucked away in the splendid isolation of the Indian Ocean, Mauritius is a haven for true romantics. Many couples come here just to be married in these idyllic surroundings. But this is tourism with a difference. No charters, no crowds, no noise. In other words, an unspoiled paradise. Behind the sweeping white sand beaches and turquoise lagoons, the island has much more to offer, with its waterfalls and almost gothic range of volcanic mountains. There is a good tourist infrastructure, enabling the visitor to explore every corner of this beautiful island. January is the hottest month in Mauritius. It is also the time when tropical fruits such as mangoes and lychees are found in abundance. Many Mauritians grow their own. In the old central market in Port Louis, all the fruits and vegetables produced on the island make a colorful display. Port Louis is also the place to buy souvenirs, or simply to stroll along at your leisure amidst a flurry of activity.
Tout ce que
on va pleurer, moi donne-toi. Ça te faut la paille, tu peux gagner, tu fais tout kata-kata.
The capital has some fine restaurants where you can sample some of the Mauritian specialities. You can also eat quite cheaply by buying from the many street vendors. Look out for these meals on wheels, Mauritian style. The dal puri is a firm favorite with everyone. Served with chilies and pickle, it's a nice change from a sandwich. As night falls, what better way to end the day than with a taste of Mauritian cuisine and island entertainment? This is the sega, the music of Mauritius. Many years ago, it was the lament of African slaves as they toiled in the cane fields. Today, it is the island's musical heritage.
Frère de Dieu ici qui chante le séga depuis l'âge de 25 ans. Il en a 86 aujourd'hui. Il vient d'une famille où le séga a toujours été de la fête.
Alors aussi vrai mon papa, partout côté côté allé moi à l'église, il tient une grande santé. Alors dans l'âge de 25 ans, moi aussi je commence à santé.
Moi qui donne salmi, le fond, moi qui donne salmi, le fond, donne salmi.
L'étoile, l'océan indien. Ça qui vient ici, l'alialé, les bisins d'accord. Qui m'ont pas menti, ça qui me dit mon appénanto.
But this is the sega which captivates the guests at the hotels. These rhythmic sounds will stay with the visitor as a constant reminder of this island and its beautiful people.
Aïe,
My visit had come to an end. It was time for the goodbyes.
Je vois des roses dans un jardin.
The same Air Mauritius plane which brought me to the sunshine of my homeland would soon whisk me back to the freezing cold of Heathrow. My stay was brief, but I savored every day, every hour, every minute. I breathed in the familiar smells of trees and flowers and those of my favorite foods, hoping they would linger with me long after my return to Wales.
Tu trouveras toutes les choses qu'ici on ne voit pas. Toute une ville qui s'endort la nuit.
I went back to the house where I was born and that same street which was once my playground.
Quand j'ai quitté ce coin de mon enfance, je savais déjà que j'y laissais mon cœur.
These familiar surroundings brought back many memories. Although they belonged to a distant past, they were vivid and seemed like yesterday.
Et il me semble que je m'entends leur dire, je reviendrai un jour un beau matin parmi vos rires.
Only those who have left their homeland for faraway places understand the significance of having one's roots. Roots which you can return to from time to time, if only to top up the spirit with a renewed sense of one's identity. Only by the grace of God do some of us enjoy this unique privilege.
J'en ai plein mon cœur des souvenirs. Je les porte en vrac, mes souvenirs. La rue où je jouais, notre jardin. Les tartines à 4 heures et les copains. Un enfant, ça rêve de grandir. Ça ne voit pas le temps s'enfuir. Et quand un beau matin il se croit vieux, le voilà parti sans un adieu. Le paradis perdu de notre adolescence, ce monde merveilleux débordant d'insouciance. Bientôt on les regrette, mais la roue a tourné. Il est trop tard, les jeux sont terminés. J'en ai plein mon cœur des souvenirs, des trésors de gosses qui font sourire. Le cheval en carton, l'épée de bois, le bateau taillé dans une noix. On faisait des châteaux de sable sur la plage, la mer les abattait dans un élan sauvage. Alors le jour suivant, on les faisait plus grands. Rien ne détruit l'espoir chez un enfant. Chacun porte en soi ses souvenirs, chacun a envie de revenir, revivre avec tendresse toute sa jeunesse dans le pays de ses souvenirs. J'en ai plein mon cœur des souvenirs.